While addressing the media at the police headquarters in Naguru, police spokesperson Freddy Nanga disclosed that last week they received complaints of a suspected bomb explosion in Banda 2, Nakawa Division. Upon getting the info, police detectives swung into action and cordoned off the home of Collins Mugabe, who was found with suspected improvised explosive devices.
Our director of counterterrorism managed to arrest a suspect who was manufacturing or constructing improvised explosive devices in Banda. Of course, one of the IEDs went off mistakenly, I think, when he tampered with it.
From Mugabe's home, police also discovered a number of bomb-making materials, including jerry cans of nitric acid, methanol, ethanol, potassium nitrate, several wires, notes and textbooks on bomb making. Police are now interrogating him to ascertain whether he has any links to rebel activities.
We recovered a second IED and an assortment of other bomb making materials. We had three jerry cans of nitric acid, there was methanol, ethanol, potassium nitrate, notes and textbooks on bomb making materials, and so on and so forth. So he had taken steps and constructed two IEDs, one of which went off mistakenly after he tampered with it.
Mugabe's arrest follows heightened security in different parts of the country following a terror alert issued by the UK government early this month. Meanwhile, police are finalizing their investigations regarding the suspected poisoning of students at Nakanyonyi Senior Secondary School in Mukono last week.
54 were rushed to Vision Hospital and 17 at Mukono General Hospital. The 17 were in critical condition, but they were all discharged and like I indicated last week, they were out of danger and the school-going activities at Nakanyonyi Secondary School continue.
Enanga noted that samples from the scene are still being examined by the forensic laboratory experts to determine the main source of the suspected poisoning, which was in the food that they ate.
Now, what is remaining is us connecting the findings from the forensic laboratory to try to establish the source of the substances, the source of the content and traces of the substances. So that is what is still pending.
From the Directorate of Traffic and Road Safety, overspeeding, lack of patience by drivers, and reckless overtaking have been mentioned as the major causes of road accidents that are happening across the country. Last week alone, 79 people were killed in 451 road crashes.
The causes of these accidents were speeding and improper overtaking.
Kananula also disclosed that there is a lot of impunity and disrespect on the road, which has led to the increased road carnage.
We therefore, I warn the entire public that they must, all road users must, observe the speed limits on all roads. They must also have discipline on roads.
Rachel Nachuala reporting for the news.